Alright, everybody, we're back with part 5. And, yeah, let's check out Planet D Hoonib, episode 4-1, The Alleyway.
Team to base. We've got that fugitoid cornered in Sector 4.
Roger. Bag him and tag him, Bravo. General Blank wants it in one piece.
That was unpleasant.
What?
Take cover! This fugitoid's got some kind of secret weapon!
No, I don't!
What happened? That light! The strange lab! Those weird robot aliens! Where'd they go?
You mean, where'd we go?
Someplace I don't think we're supposed to be.
The natives don't look too friendly.
I think our best defense might be
some serious butt-kicking ninja action!
Alright. 4-1, let's go. This is the episode where we have to take the fugitoid and pick him up. And, bring him to safety. And thankfully, one of my viewers commented telling me how to pick things up, and just in time for the only episode where you actually need to pick someone up. And I remember as a kid this episode always gave me a hard time.
We turtles are friends for a week. I'm the only chance you've got.
I guess we can go take these guys out. Maybe. I hate the fact that they can shoot me from long range with guns. I guess it is pretty cool though. And they die pretty fast, which is nice. And if they're just going to keep respawning back there, I'm already past there, so why am I going to go fight them again? Oh, jeez. Look out, fugitoid. Damn, fugitoid went a long way. Jeez. Alright, to attack these.
I'll give you a good taste of my staff.
Am I? Oh, it already died. But the flying things can get a little bit annoying, that's for sure. And those certainly get annoying. Those exploding things. It's so hard to land an aerial attack. Strange. Oh wow. It blew up again. Ooh. There we go. Alright, come on, fugitoid, get up. Okay, I don't get why they don't pick him up sometimes. As you see, every time that you throw a fugitoid, he loses some health, so you gotta be smart. How did that not explode them? If you guys knew this game, you'd know that the blast radius for those is pretty big, so... Got a few more bad guys. Take this guy out with some shurikens, we got so many. Come on. Why does that happen? What? I swear, the controls in this game are just wacko sometimes. Come on, Fugitoid. Yeah, we got through that level pretty easily, actually. And I think we might have used... Yeah, we used every turtle. B's and C's. But we got an A. Continuing our streak of all A's and B's. Next up, 4-2. The sewers under Peblack.
Yeah! Fan out! Search the street!
So, what is your story? Why are those soldiers after you?
Yes, I do owe you a full explanation. You see, I am Professor Honeycutt. My name is Honeycutt, although I've been reclassified as the Fugitoid. A freak accident caused my mind to be transferred into the body of a robot.
Find that Fugitoid!
I am being hunted down by some rather uncouth gentlemen from my own government who want to force me to build my intergalactic teleportal device as a weapon of mass destruction.
Guys, are you thinking what I'm thinking?
That an extra large serving of Kung Pao chicken would be really good right now?
The professor's teleportal, right?
Right. If the professor here can build his teleportal,
then we could use it to go home.
Home.
All right, the sewage garbage system coming at us. Just a tip for this episode, everybody, do not use Leonardo, because he breaks things as he dashes, as you know. And when you're dashing on this and the camera angle is not good, so you cannot see what's in front of you, you end up getting screwed over a lot using Leonardo. He'll break all of those explosives and end up just damaging yourself over and over again. So just a quick tip, everybody, do not use Leonardo. And just keep running. This is a pretty silly episode. A pretty silly level. But whatever. I'd rather be on the skate or on a skateboard or a hoverboard right now, like the other levels. Oh, almost got away from him. Oh. How did I not get that? I went right through it. Alright. That's the last of the sewer cleaner. These mousers explode so damn close to you, unlike the last game where they get a little staticky. And it's very hard to avoid their explosions.
We can't let our guard down yet.
Alright, we use strictly Wrath on that level. And definitely did not get the needed items. Got an A team performance though, not sure how. Alright, episode 4-3, Junction of the Sewers.
Yeah!
This episode, if I remember, has a lot of plants and bats.
I'm finally up!
Ooh. I like the close camera angles only when they show the turtles, because the graphics in this game are what I like a lot. I guess if I'm gonna use shurikens, Donnie's the one to use. Uh-oh. And that happens a lot on this level. Jesus, how fast can he attack? Oh, finally! An explosive exploded, and I didn't get hurt. Oh my god, yeah. Someone told me that, in the comments, that Donatello is really good for, the bats. So hopefully that's true.
You know not to play with fire?
Alright, these shurikens should be hitting the plant. Yep, they just fly right into Donnie's bow staff. And it's a strong attack too, so it kills him fast. How many are there? Got him pretty fast. How did that not destroy or kill these guys? I don't know. I guess considering I blazed through some of these episodes, I'll kill all of these guys for your viewing pleasures. Oh. Leo is a pretty cheap way to kill him too. He just runs into him. These guys on the walls, looks like you just want to attack him from the side. Damn. These bats are insane, the amount that they throw at me right now. Yep, gonna switch back to Donnie. Ooh. And I definitely feel like these bats are a lot stronger than the ones in the underground parts.
What kind of damage this laser gun can do? Man, my thirst.
Uh-oh, yeah. This is the episode with who I thought we'd be versing. I won't spoil it, but if you know the game, you'll know. And it's a really cool villain that should have made more... Yeah, I guess it is a little outlandish, but you'll see.
What's that all about? I'd say it's a bunch of rats playing ninja. With a turtle sensei? As ninjas, they'd never measure up to us, of course. Hey, you green freaks!
Would you care to repeat that?
Because it sounded like you said
that we were playing ninja.
Mikey, you have an uncanny ability to rub people the wrong way.
They're extremely, how should I put it, strong-willed. Suffice to say, they're a hard-headed species. Tangling with them could mean trouble.
Sorry, we didn't mean anything by it. If we hurt your feelings, we apologize. Come on, you too, Mikey. You know if Master Splinter were here, he'd tell you to exercise courtesy in all things.
Fine, I apologize. Your, ninja skills aren't bad at all. Keep up the practice and someday you might be as good as us.
Mikey,
I gather from what you've said that you too are ninjas. If so, there is no need for words. Far better to test your styles one against another. Shall we call it a contest then?
All right. These guys aren't bad guys. They're just a friendly foe.
These guys are pretty quick.
Oh jeez.
If we let them drown us, we'll regret it.
Oh, wow. Holy. These guys are crazy. I guess I'm just gonna run around with Leo.
Now there's nothing to fear.
Not exactly how to go about these guys. Of course, Leo battling with Leo. Oh, I thought Mikey, the Mikey Rat was dead for a second. They're good with the shurikens. That's for sure. Oh, they have shovels. There's some health. These guys definitely aren't funny. I guess we'll finish them off with Mikey. He hasn't done anything yet. Come on, one or two more hits. Screw it. Alright.
What do you say to that? Who's the strongest now?
Hold on. Is that really what we're fighting about?
Blast all!
You all aren't half bad!
But you better keep one thing in mind.
We barely put half our ability into that last belt.
Well, I've got news for you too. We Ninja Turtles only used 40% of ours. No, 30%. Nah, really more like 20%.
Enough of that, Mikey. Remember Master Sane. The true way of the warrior is to avoid battle when possible and never make enemies unnecessarily.
Ah, it seems your master is one to reckon with.
Person, huh? Maybe more like a great big, rat?
A rat, you say? I see. This grows more and more fascinating. I would venture that our paths will someday cross again.
What do you mean?
Some might call it fate. Our meeting with you here was a cosmological inevitability. I anxiously await our next meeting.
Usually in the 2003 series, when someone says that they're gonna come back, they do. But, pretty sure that's the last time that we see the Ninja Rats in this game and the series. Donnie with the MVP. Yeah! And we got an S. Awesome. Alright, everybody. Next episode. Well, I guess we'll be going straight down. I guess we'll check it out right now. I guess we'll do it right now, actually. Screw it. We'll make this one a long one. Episode 4-4, Industrial Plant. Looks like we're cornered. Damn, this is a big, big map. Come on, who are you messing with?
Oh no, what can I do now?
Not messing with these explosives, that's for sure. Let's just see what's up here. Worthless. Whoa! Oh, jeez. Falling to our death. Oh, jeez. Never mind. Just taking some damage.
Now's the time to put my training to the test.
Guess we have to. Yeah. Ooh. Finally, we get an antique. They've been few and far between, I feel. Some more health. Some more health. Very generous in this, in this one. I like the frozen, that is cool. Where was that flying? There it is. I do not know.
What can I do now?
He's so evasive, he keeps running away from me, it's hard to one of my bigger fans, Large Foot Ninja. Look at these. Large, Federation Army guys. I want to kill this thing first. It's been annoying this whole time.
Couldn't start without me.
I thought see if Donnie can do it. See, look, where's he even flying? Not towards me. Alright, Mikey might be a little bit better for this guy. Looks like a flying hermit crab. Yeah, these things are very annoying. Screw it. I don't think this is the end. Oh, I guess it is. Got an antique. Leo with the A. Another S. Alright, episode 4-5, Deepest Industrial Plant. Yeah! All of these have had cutscenes at some point. It's very cool, it makes it entertaining. Damn, these guys can take a hit. Put a full combo into them. Oh, we were timed too?
Just run for it. It's all we can do.
Alright, well, where do we have to go then? This is strange. Alright. Now we found a way.
Don't you know not to play with fire?
Jesus, these shurikens. Get out.
I battle for justice and honor and to protect my family.
Oh, thank God that didn't kill me. Alright. Aim for the. Oh, are you kidding me? This is
the star of the show, don't you think?
Of course, we would have already been done with this, but you guys seen what happened.
Thought I couldn't handle a throwing star? You wish.
Man, needed to get that health. Alright, when in doubt, go to Leo. Whew. Alright, screw it, actually. How am I getting shot at from this far away while throwing shurikens? Hopefully those shurikens do a good amount of damage as well. Not sure how these aren't hitting these guys, but... here we go. This thing better go fast. Wow, with 2 seconds to spare.
This is the end of the line, Fugitoid. General Blank's been waiting for you. And you aliens had better not get any ideas.
I see the Federation Army is as incompetent as ever.
Who goes there?
D Do you really think you're a match for me? If so, that only further proves your incompetence.
Why, it's Slasher! Don't tell me you hired on with the Triceratons! Get him! Fire! Fire!
Superconductor? What's that armor of his made out of? Professor, who is this guy?
If what the Federation Commander says is true, he can only be Slasher. I've heard stories of him since I was a child. Whenever a battle arose in the universe, he was sure to be there. After surviving all of these battles, he became known as the strongest mercenary in the universe.
Those toys of yours didn't leave a scratch. Well, a job is a job, so be it. Ah, Professor Honeycutt. This is our first meeting, but I've heard much about you. Unfortunately, my contract with my client, the Triceraton Republic, specifies that I must escort you to them. Is that clear? It seems you've hired some loyal and able bodyguards yourself.
Are we really versing him right now? I didn't think... Oh, wow.
Leave it to me and my blade.
Jesus, look how much... Look at the health that we started off with. We need to, find some. There we go. Maybe a little bit more.
I'm not gonna have to pay for this, am I?
I thought I'd never get a piece of the action. What? Does that armor work like a shield or something? That hit the spot. I feel a bit better already.
Jesus. He is a tough one. That's for sure.
I'm the only chance you've got.
That might be the only chance we have is dashing. Can I get a combo on him? There we go. We're definitely playing it safe.
The techniques are reminiscent of him.
This might be our only option. Damn, with the amount of health that we had, this is scary. We're getting there. Got him. Whew, that was clutch.
For someone who claims to be best in the universe, you ain't all that.
I'll let you off this time. The Triceratons won't like it, but I've never been one to take jobs that don't pay anyway. I have one question for you. What is your home planet?
It's a planet called Earth, in the Milky Way.
Ah, Earth. I see. Then your master must be Hamato Yoshi.
How do you know Master Yoshi?
Save that question for Hamato Yoshi himself. I imagine we'll meet again. Until then, I leave you with your lives. Above all else, grow stronger. I await our next meeting.
Unlike the ninja rats, we actually will see Slasher again. Ooh. Mikey with a double S. I think think that's the first one we've seen of those so far. For defense. Only good enough for an A, though. Alright, everybody. We're over the half-hour point in this episode, so I definitely think it's time to call this one quits. Next time, we'll pick up on hopefully 5-1. I like to do all these episodes where the first number, so episode 4, I like doing all of those in one episode. But I think it might be 4-6 next episode. So, yeah, guys, see you then, and thanks for watching.